Tonight on Access TV, it's Gotham Comedy Live. Get ready to laugh with Sean Jackson, Courtney Sherman, Rod Reyes, Eddie Ibb. This week's host, Joy Behar. Gotham Comedy Live, all happening right now. Ladies and gentlemen, Joy Behar.
Okay, welcome to Gotham Comedy Live. Here we are. Where are we? Okay, so isn't it nice to be here tonight? I'm thrilled to be here. What lovely, beautiful people we have here. Lovely, beautiful. I used to teach before I did this, you know. I used to teach English to the high school dropouts in the worst neighborhood in New York. Were you in my class? It's possible. You know the kind of kids who go to jail because they set fire to their parents? Then they would send them to me to teach them the difference between who and whom. That was the job. And I would try to make it relevant. I'd say, whom do you wish to murder, not who? Then I switched over to elementary school because I figured they don't pack a piece in the third grade. You know, you're scared of them. But they'd send me to like this one of these goody-goody suburban schools where the kids would just snitch on each other all day long. I hate that, don't you? I come from, I'm Italian, we don't fucking snitch. Miss Behar, he said F. Miss Behar, he said F. I was like, leave me alone, I'm putting on my mascara here. They were relentless. Miss Behar, I finally one day I said, okay, who the fuck said F? Who the fuck, and I got fired, you know? Yeah, well, they snitched on me, the little bastards. So you may know me from The View. Do you know The View? Yeah. Well, I had to leave last year because I was getting a contact high from Whoopi Goldberg. All afternoon, I have the munchies. I'm putting on weight. I have no idea why. You know? But a lot of people would not come on the show because of me. Imagine that, a sweet thing like me. Sarah Palin, for example, would not come on the show. She told Barbara Walters I was too hard on her. Do you know who Sarah is, don't you? Yeah. Oh, yeah. I said, Sarah, come to New York. We'll shoot some rats in Central Park. We'll look at pictures of Russia at my house. It'll be great. But no, she didn't want to come. John McCain, Senator McCain, remember him? Yeah. Okay, well, he came on one time, and I said to him, Senator, you know, you're running these ads that say that President Obama wants to teach kindergarten kids sex education. I said, you know that's a lie. Why do you say you approve those messages? Right? Well, he was furious, and his wife was furious, and they stormed out of the place, and they said, we're never coming back here. Now, wasn't this guy, was held captive by the Viet Cong. I don't know if you know that. They left him out in the blazing sun to get skin cancer. They broke his arms. They waterboarded him, and yet years later, he went back and he forgave the Viet Cong. But The View, no. What a pathetic group is running for office now. Have you been following this at all? Like this guy Huckabee. You know who he is? He's a little chunky. He wants everyone to be a Christian. If that happens, who's going to do my taxes? That's what I want to know. And I was reading that he said that it's trashy for women to curse at the workplace. What the fuck is his problem? He's like so annoying. He can't even get a date on Christian Mingles, this guy. I mean, and how about anybody from New Jersey? So you have Chris Christie, your governor, Chris Christie. You like him? No. Do you know who he is? Well, there was a scandal recently, a bridge scandal. I don't know if you're aware of this. He was accused of stopping four lanes of traffic for political reasons on the George Washington Bridge. When I heard this, I said, what is he doing, standing in the middle of the bridge? I'll tell you something. It's a good thing that Ramona from the Mob Wives was not on that bridge that day, or this fat fuck would have been floating in the Hudson River face down. He wants to be president. He wants to reach Americans. He can't even reach his toes, this guy. I'll tell you another thing. He's still fat. He had the operation, you know. The sleeve or the pant leg. I don't know what it was. And he's still fat. It didn't work. He should have done that other surgery, you know, the more extreme where they attach your throat to your rectum. That would have worked. What we need is I want a president that'll bring us a good sex scandal again. We haven't had that. Obama, you know, the only sex scandal that he's involved with is when he pulled out of Iraq. You know what I mean? We need a good sex scandal, you know, like bring Clinton back. Right? He's hot, isn't he hot? He's old, but he's hot. But I know, the women used to love Bill Clinton because Here's the reason, I think. He used to go out with women who look like most women, like the rest of us. No, some of you are more gorgeous than that, but some of us, okay? I mean, JFK, if you read your history, he had to have Marilyn Monroe, models, Angie Dickinson, a beautiful girl, beautiful actress, you know? But Clinton, he liked a fat ass, and we enjoyed that about him. Right? I mean, Monica Lewinsky, who's back in the news now, you know? She was madly in love with him, and I know why. I know why. Because he used to tell her she looked thin. That is the reason. She would go into the Oval Office, and he'd say, Monica, did you lose weight? I mean, who wouldn't blow a guy like that? Come on. You tell me I look thin, I'm on my knees, okay? And, you know, I'll give you a little history. You know, the whole thing with Clinton was back in the day when he was the Arkansas governor, Paula Jones, this woman, accused him of exposing himself to her, right? And, you know, I'm a feminist. I wanted to believe her. I'm a good feminist. I did, you know, natural childbirth, no eye makeup, no lipstick. And I really wanted to believe this girl. She said that she can identify his genitalia. And because it had some special demarcation. What do you think it was? I'm driving myself crazy all these years trying to figure out what could it have been. Did it furl out into the American flag? We know it swung to the left, but other than that... But, you know, maybe to a girl from Arkansas, a circumcised penis was a special demarcation. You know, she went home and she said, Mama, it was wearing a hat. So I don't believe it, unfortunately, because I was married for 16 years the first time. I couldn't pick out my husband's pecker in a police lineup. I don't even remember his face. You know what else we do on the show? I've met a lot of people. I mean, I met, a lot of movie stars and people. I mean, Andrea Bocelli used to come on a lot, the singer. You know who he is? But I don't think he's blind. I really don't. I mean, he's always looking down, staring at my tits. I'm just saying. I don't think he's blind. I think it's a gimmick, you know. The three tenors had a gimmick, had to come up with something. And anyway, let's assume that he's blind for the sake of argument. Why does he have to have a gorgeous girlfriend? He can't see her. They could tell him she looks like Angelina Jolie. She could look like, I don't know, Paul Giamatti? I don't know. Stevie Wonder, another allegedly blind guy, also has a gorgeous wife. It's like, it's a waste of the beauty. It's like giving lobster to a bulimic. You see what I'm saying? We had on, what's his name? Robert Wagner. Anybody know who he is? R.J. Wagner. I know, I'm the oldest person in the room here, I think. But Robert Wagner actually came on to me. See, these are the type of guys who come on to me. But first of all, he said to me, what are you wearing? I said, gardenia. He said, oh, Natalie used to wear that. Morbid. But Natalie Wood, you don't know the story. But anyway. He was flirting with me, but I thought, these are the type of guys who are coming on to me now, the type of guys who do reverse mortgage commercials. I'm waiting for a call from Fred Thompson any day now. All right. Thank you, everybody. I'm rappy.
Access TV, live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City. Sean Jackson is taking the stage when we return. Welcome back to the Access TV presentation of Gotham Comedy Live. More laughs happening right now.
Okay, our first guest tonight is a very funny guy, and this is his TV debut. So be nice. Well, don't be. I don't really give a shit. Here he is, Sean Jackson.
Yeah. All right. I will say I just got God into my life. Give it up for that. I've really became religious ever since. Amazing things have been happening to me. The other day, I was walking down the street, and I found $500 right in this lady's purse. I was like, damn, the Lord works in mysterious ways. I just got fired from my job. I used to work at this grocery store called Giant. Giant had the nerve to fire me, talking about they caught me on camera eating pineapple out the salad bar in the back. They gonna call me in the office, like, Sean, we gotta let you go. You eating all the pineapple. This is unsanitary. I was like, no, this is racist. Because every single day I take some watermelon, and ain't nobody say shit. soon as I go for the pineapple, I done overstepped my boundaries now. I done stumbled across the Mason-Dixon fruit line or something. Security watching the camera like, not the seedless. I don't know why they did the hammer dance. I don't know. The other day, I went to the movies, parked my car at the edge of the parking lot. I get out of the car, I'm walking through the cars to get to the entrance. Just so happened to come up on an old lady sitting in her car. As soon as I get close to her door, she gonna lock all the damn doors real fast. Like, click, like I was gonna rob her old ass. So I acted like I was gonna rob her old ass. I heard that click, I reached for the door like, you lucky. You're good. You got some good reflexes. You play tennis? I was like, huh, you're like, huh, like, huh, you're like, huh. I'm gonna have to come back next week. Then I started rapping DMX, like, I should have blood for my niggas. She was like, no, no. She had a life alert, like, doop. Life alert. Random rapping. I hate that. I hate random rapping. I know you do too. I know you've been in the train in the morning, going to work, minding your business. Some young thugs come on the train rapping for no reason. I'm in love with the cocoa. Baking soda. I got baking soda. White people looking at me like, do you know these motherfuckers? I'm sitting there like, no, I'm scared too. I'm light-skinned. I bruise easily. You know what I'm saying? This ain't no thug complexion. Sometimes I be feeling like these thugs be subliminally rapping at me, like trying to throw me messages. I'm in a Chinese store late night, little young thugs gonna walk in, look me up and down like, psst. Smack a light-skinned, big-head nigga in the face. I'm the only nigga in the store. I'm like, is he talking about me? He was like, I'm bringing the pain, robbing motherfuckers for shrimp lo mein. How he know I'm ordering shrimp lo mein? I wanted to rap something back, but you know, my raps don't go fast like 2004. I was like, don't think about it too much. I'm pulling out Mystical, like, shake it fast. Watch it, son. I'm pulling out Ja Rule, what would I be without you? He's like, what? I know you're tired of being lonely. I blame it on media. I blame it on advertising, how they divide us. You ever watch a Lexus commercial? It's always like a rich white guy riding through a perfectly paved suburban sidewalk or some stuff. He pull up to a mansion. It's like, Lexus, December to remember. With the red bow on top. He's like, oh, that made me feel good. Then you turn on a Chrysler commercial. Some black dude riding through the hood of Detroit. He pull up to a crack house. He'd be like, Chrysler, don't forget where you came from. Don't forget where I came from. Or they got the life-size gerbil pop locking on top of a Kia with a do-rag on. He's like, who gave this gerbil a do-rag? It'd be all dangling out the back. Like, yo, if you don't tie that shit up, this ain't NWA 1992 no more. What is this? Nobody let the do-rag dangle no more. Car commercials are fake. Fake. It's always a professional driver in a Lexus or a Jaguar skidding through a desert or going up in a Jeep up a muddy mountain. Like, some shit you ain't never gonna do with the car. You know what I'm saying? If you want me to buy the car, the commercial should be real. The commercial should be a dude driving home drunk. Because I do that shit a lot. You know what I'm saying? He should be swerving through lanes like, oh, sure. He come up to something real sad crossing the street like a white woman, slam on his brakes and miss her. But then a dude in a cheaper car comes up drunk, slams his brakes, kills the white woman. The camera flashed back to the first car. He like, shit. Good thing I bought a Lexus. These brakes are amazing. This is a December to remember. And then the other car, I'd be a gerbil with a do-rag on, like, ah, shit, ah. My do-rag got in my face. I knew I should have tied it up. Or if it was a Chrysler commercial, it should be a black dude riding through the hood, blasting his music. He pulled up to a crack house, and then some crackheads looking at his car, like, ooh. But then a dude in the Lexus parks right next to him, and the crackheads robbed the dude in the Lexus. And the dude in the Chrysler's like, good thing I remember where I came from. Who brings the Lexus into the hood? I don't know, just that. That's how it goes, man. I'm not a thug. It's hard being single when you're not a thug. You know, it's hard dating, doing that stuff. You know, me and this girl, I don't know why he clapped for that. He's like, yo, me too, bro. I was on a Tinder date with this girl. We walking down the street. We came up on a, yes, a Tinder date. Stop judging me, people. I do a lot of swiping left. We walking down the street. We come up on a group of like big Italian dudes. One of them must have had two testosterone shots. He wanna shout out like, yo, bro, she got some big ass titties. Then he high-fived all his friends, like, big titties, big titties, big titties, big titties. So, you know, me being the man that I am, I acted like I ain't even hear him. I kept walking. We get like a block, now she looking at me like, you just gonna let him disrespect me? I'm like, you being disrespectful, you ain't even say thank you. Where are your manners? Females don't know how to take compliments anymore. You don't. Y'all like to come out the house, titties all popping out the top of the shirt like they need oxygen or sunlight or some shit. Booty all sucked up in the little tights and the little mini skirts. But as soon as you catch me looking, I'm a pervert now. You know what I'm saying? Like, I did something wrong. You look at me like, ah, pervert. I'm like, I'm pretty sure them titties been out all day. One day I'm gonna walk down the street in my boxers and I'm gonna let my ball sack hang out that little slit up front. I'm just gonna yell at every chick like, oh, you pervert. What? Let's get out of here, Carl. I don't feel safe. I'm gonna put like glitter on him and swing him around like, what the fuck is she looking at, Carl? Let's get out of here right now. A man can't walk around with his balls hanging out. The other day, I chased this lady home by accident. I don't even know how I did this. I got off the train like 3 o'clock in the morning. I'm walking down the street, lady walking in front of me. She turned left at the corner. I'm going the same way. I turn left behind her. She go down and she make another right. I'm going the same way. I turn right behind her. Now she all grabbing her bag, looking over her shoulder. I'm right behind her. I'm looking over my shoulder like, is somebody behind us? Are we in danger right now? She started walking faster. I started walking faster. She running. I'm running. She's screaming. I'm screaming. Like, yo, we about to die. Get in the house. She ran in the house. I'm banging on the door like, let me in too. She like, you trying to kill me. I'm like, he's trying to kill us. She like, well, why are your balls hanging out? I'm like, oh, you are a pervert. What the fuck? Hey, I'm Sean Jackson, everybody. That's my time. Enjoy the rest of the show.
Stay tuned for more laughs on Access TV, live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City. Courtney Sherman is taking the stage when we return. Welcome back to the Access TV presentation of Gotham Comedy Live. More laughs happening right now.
Okay, now we're bringing up a girl, another, a lady, I should say. I shouldn't say girls. We're not girls. We're men. Okay. So this is another never been on television, another virgin. So please give her a warm welcome, Courtney Sherman. Woo! What is up? Yeah. I know what you guys are wondering right now. The answer is yes, they're real. Hey, some guys don't mind, okay? I got hit on the other day. This guy, he came up to me, he was like, yo, what's up, little mama? Yo, how you doing, little mama? Yo, you good? You good? I was like, well, first of all, you're Asian, so. But then he continued, he's like, yo, what you doing with them little titties, girl? Yo, I'm into them little titties. And I was like, oh, they're just nipples. Yeah. And they're fucking angry right now, okay? They're just like, don't touch me. Like, no one is, that's cool. I get insecure, I do. I'm not even wearing a bra right now. Yeah, no, it's a training bra. It's awful, especially when I'm with a guy for the first time, you know, like he'll go to unhook the bra. I just raise my hands like, pull up! He's like, get out! I'm like, the car's still moving. Yeah. It's messed up. My best friend's fifth grader has bigger breasts than I do. Okay, and it's a boy. He's chubby, guys. All tiny twisters. No. It's messed up. My mom tells me I got my boobs from my dad. That's not funny. No, because she can't say that to my sister, okay? My sister's got a body, okay? It's ridiculous. Like, my sister walks into a room and, like, it's a situation, you know what I mean? Like guys act crazy. Like, they'll drop things. Like, they will drop everything. Like, they'll drop their families, you know? They drop their habits. So this one guy, he dropped a baby. I was like, what the fuck? It's fucking nuts. And, you know, it's whatever, you know? She was adopted, so. I still got that going for me. Oh, that's weird. No, just cause I'm not trying to make adoption a joke. That's not a. Again, no, it's a beautiful thing. It was, and actually, in my house, like growing up, like we didn't even really talk about it, you know. No. No, not unless we were in a fight, you know. Well, no, my sister was an asshole. Okay, like growing up, she would look at me and she'd be like, "Mom says that you have man hips," and I'd be like, "You mean my mom?" No, I was the victim. Okay, I was. She'd be like, "You're a skinny brat," and I'd be like, I'd cry. I'd be like, "Stop calling me skinny. Like, I can't help it. Mom and Dad are skinny. It's genetic." Ah, that was my comeback, like, every time, just like, it's genetic. She'd be like, how come Courtney doesn't have to do the dishes. And I'd be like, you wouldn't understand. It's genetic. No, okay, but this is my issue. All right, this is it. Everybody always feels bad for the adopted kid, right? And like, look, I get it, all right? No one wanted her, whatever. But what about me, you know? What about my pain, right? I mean, as a kid, I didn't understand what was going on, right? Like, I was literally like, I thought we were getting a dog, you know? Like, they came home with my replacement, you know? If we're really being honest, guys, the bitch stole my parents, okay? She did. It was literally like, it was like a playdate came over and just never went home, you know? Like, I would look at her, like, months later, I'd be like, don't you have somebody coming for you? But, you know, my parents set it up bad. They did. They set this emotionally. They didn't take care of it. I remember them sitting us down and being like, okay, now, Courtney, we had you, but we chose Tiffany. No, and it was hard. It was so hard. We didn't have money. Like, growing up, my family, we didn't have money. Like, I remember, like, my girlfriends, like going off for family vacations, you know? Like, oh, we're going to Hawaii, or, like we're going to Disneyland. And I'd be like, oh, Disneyland? Huh. Yeah, that sounds fun. Yeah, no, the Shermans can't afford it. No, because my parents bought a human. Yeah, so we're just gonna go camping. Yeah, that's what you do. That's what, you know, you gotta... Humans are expensive, guys. You gotta go camping. You gotta eat off-brand Doritos. You gotta wear your brother's underwear. It's. I'm kidding. Okay. No, he wore mine. No, I love my sister to death. As we grew up, you know, we're really close now. When I introduced her to people, I love this because everybody, they assume that she was adopted. Because she's actually got a little black in her. Almost every night. So that's like. That's her jam, you know? My mom calls it a phase. Like, she's like, no, it's just a phase. I'm like, Mom, they're married. That's fucked up, you know? I've gone through some phases myself. I just went through this phase. I was only dating older men, you know? Like, oh, fucking wrinkles, yeah. I loved it. My girlfriends thought it was disgusting. Like, they'd be like, why? Like... Why would you like a man that's old enough to be your dad, you know? And I'd be like, oh, well, you're just mad because it is your dad, you know? Yeah. I'm doing your daddy, you know? I've tried dating younger guys. I have. I'm just going to say this. You're judgy. You're judgy as shit. Knock it off, all right? Older guys, they don't care, right? Oh, they don't. Like, I could have a lazy eye in a colostomy bag. He's just happy I'm there. You know what I mean? Like, younger guys, sorry to be vulgar, but they finish in a room. You know, it's like they're giving you a present. You know what I mean? Like yeah, like, there you go. Like, I did that for you. Yeah. Is there a return policy? Older guys, it's like the last time, every time, just fucking taking it home. It's awesome. If I offended anybody about the adoption stuff, I just want to say my sister's the best thing that happened to my family. I'm a huge supporter of adoption, and I think that if there's enough love in a family, that things really do come full circle. My mom was recently diagnosed with breast cancer. She's fine, guys. She'll live. But we were in the hospital getting the prognosis, and I look over at my sister, and she was bawling. She was just heaving, and I was like, you know, Tiff, are you okay? And she's like, yeah, I'm just really worried about you. It's genetic. And I was like, she won, you guys. She won. You guys have been awesome. My name's Courtney Sherman. Thank you so much.
Stay tuned for more laughs on Access TV, live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City. Maude Reyes is taking the stage when we return.
A great guy. You're going to love him. Rod Reyes, who's from Latino Laughter. Oh, yeah. Rod, come on. Thank you.
Thank you. It is so great to be back in New York City. If you are visiting, see as much of this city as you can.
Advise your friends to see as much of this city as they can. It is one of the most spectacular wonders of the world. It can be intimidating, and that's why we offer tour guides, qualified professionals whose only job is to enhance and improve your Big Apple experience. That is very cool. You know what we don't have? Tour guides that were born in New York City. All of a sudden, a lifetime in Uganda qualifies you to show me my own hometown. And if I had so many Africans coming at me, it's like, come with me, my friend, come with me. Come with me, my friend. I will show you the sights of New York. Over there is the Empire Statue of Liberty building. It is very tall, my friend. It would take a monkey a long time to climb to the top. Over there is FAO Schwartz. They make bagels for children. And the entire time I'm thinking, do you think they have tour guides from America in Nigeria? Like you get off the plane and it's Vinny from Brooklyn. He's like, hey, everybody! Focus your attention! Oh, a freaking lion! I love New York, but it can be politically correct. On the way over here, I saw a protest rally to lower the size requirements for firemen. People want to make it easier to become a New York City fireman because apparently little people are running around the city going, we have a right to become firemen! No, Gelflings, no! The last thing anybody wants to see when they're in the 90th story of a burning building is some little half a Mexican Oompa Loompa come in there. Follow me, follow me! I know the way out! We can fit through the pipe! I represent the Lollipop Guild! Off to the races. So let me tell you some things the Rod Man will not talk about. I do not talk about porn, because porn does not answer the questions that I have about porn. Such as, why is it that everybody that's ever been in a porn movie, a porn star? There are no porn extras. Which is what I want to be. Just some guy in the backdrop with his junk flapping in the breeze for no other reason than to give depth and character to the story. I don't talk about weed, because there's nothing funny about an old man with short-term memory loss. You guys smoke weed and it's cool. You forget stuff, it's funny. He can't find his keys. He can't find his keys. I forget stuff. People want to put me in a home. Now, I'm not going to kid you. Back in the day, I smoked weed, a lot of weed. Maybe too much weed. You know how you might know you smoked a little too much weed? When you drop that baggie and you sweep it back up. And you sweep up twice as much as you dropped in the first one. And you shake the cat and an ounce falls out of that. Oh, you guys are uplifting my spirits. You guys are making me feel so good because it's obvious, I'm old. I'm old, there's no getting around it. I'm old, elephant in the room. Old. But here's the truth and the future. There are two kinds of people in the world. Old and soon to be old. And it's not pretty and it's not subtle. Happens like this. 1 minute you're young, you're on top of the world. The world is your oyster. You get your junk mail from Harley Davidson. Be a rebel, buy a chopper. Next minute you're like me, getting your junk mail from the scooter store. You get to a point where you actually like sleep better than you like sex. I do. Now you laugh. Riddle me this, Batman. If sex is superior to sleep, why is it that when you die and you go to your final reward, they put on your tombstone, rest in peace, not diddly through infinity? But it's not like I'm jealous. I don't resent youth. Live your lives and enjoy it. Make your own mistakes and don't let anybody tell you how to live your lives. There's nothing that I want from you, but Had they given me a choice, if they said, Rod, there is one thing you could take back from the younger generation back to yours, it would have to be cyber bullies. Yeah, because you know what they had when I was a kid? Real bullies! You know how much easier my life would have been in 1964 if all I had to deal with is, Dear Rod, you fat, stupid Puerto Rican, give me all of you our lunch dollar sign, or I will unfriend you. Real bully. The kind that would snatch your lunch money, punch you in the face. Right? And you ran 10 blocks out of the way to avoid them. And you hung out in abandoned areas so you wouldn't have to find them and nobody could find you. Where are you going to go to avoid a cyberbully? Where can you hide from a cyberbully? You're going to hang out in LinkedIn? But I'm never going to be one of these older people that tells their kids music stinks. People have been doing that forever. Right? I mean, my parents didn't like our lyrics. There was a song when I was a young man that went... You're so far away. Doesn't anybody stay in one place anymore? On first listen, a plaintive love song. On second listen, maybe a complaint from a sniper. It was a band called The Clash. People wear the shirt, never heard of the band. And they sang, should I stay or should I go now? If I go, there will be trouble. But if I stay, it will be double. Well, there's your answer. Sounds like straight mathematics to me. There's a band called The Doors, and they sang, when you're strange, no one remembers your name. When you're strange. Bullshit! When you're strange, people will remember your name till the day you die. Parents have been complaining about their kids' music as long as they've been parents, kids, and music. I'm pretty willing to bet Beethoven's father probably told him, Ach, du lieber Ludwig, how can you listen to this shit? La, 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 la. What are you, deaf? Ladies and gentlemen.
Stay tuned for more laughs on Access TV, live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City. Eddie Ip is taking the stage when we return.
Okay, our last comic has absolutely no credits. I'm looking for them. Dave, I'm searching for something. Was he on TV? Did he perform for his mother in his living room? Ungatz, as they say. Eddie Ift.
Thank you, Joy. Thank you. Joy, you look very thin. Very thin.
Wait a minute. Wait a second. I would get on my knees, but I'm afraid I won't get up.
Keep it going for her. Joy Behar, everybody. I can't believe I just put my hand on the back of Joy Behar. For a second, I'm like, what the fuck am I doing? I wish I was on The View and did that. To Whoopi. Oh my God, this is the best show I've ever done already. It is, because I'm not even a comedian. I'm part of Make-A-Wish Foundation. Good, you guys laugh at that shit. Some people don't like when you're funny. I was on stage last night, and I called a heckler a retard. And a woman got so mad after the show, she's like, I need to speak to you. And I was like, oh, I bet this is gonna be fun. I've never had that from a guy. It's always from a woman. I need to speak to you. If it's from a guy, he's like, I've got cocaine in the bathroom. But it's a woman, and she goes, I need to speak to you. I go, what? She goes, I loved your show. It was great. And I was like, yeah. She goes, until. And I was like, She says, until you called that heckler a retard. She goes, that ruined the show. In fact, it made me cry because my son is retarded. Don't laugh. I felt terrible. I did. I felt terrible, and I'm not good in those situations. I didn't know what to say. I was like, how retarded is it? Because... there's a lot of levels, and no, but like people, you know, when people get mad at words, like I hate when people get mad at a word. Like one of my best friends, not my best friend, he's like one of them. He's gay, and I live in. Shut up. We were in the dog park the other day, and we were walking our dogs, and I wanted to leave, and I go, "Let's go, faggot," and this other guy who wasn't gay goes, "You can't say that." And I go, "Faggot." He goes, "You can't say that." And I go, "Faggot." He goes, "You can't say that." And I was like, "Faggot." I was like, "Apparently I say it pretty well." And he goes, "You're not supposed to say it." I go, "But he's gay." He goes, "Then you really shouldn't say it." I go, "But he called me a faggot first." He goes, "What?" I go, "Yeah, I was sucking his dick." I was like, "Ah, ah, ah." And he was like, "Suck my dick, faggot, suck my dick." Well, the guy was gone at that point. He literally covered his ears and ran out. Like, oh. And I was like, "Goodbye, word police." I love when people like say you can't say a word. Like, that gives the word power. When you don't say that, like my gay friends call each other faggots all the time, so you can't call them that. You take the power out of the word, you know. And same way black people call each other the N-word, but I still don't call black people the N-word. Because I'm not afraid of gay people. I'm not afraid of black people either. That's a joke. I'm not afraid of black people. Unless they have a fever and they just came from Western Africa. Fuck off. You were all afraid for 2 weeks. Everybody was afraid of Ebola for 2 weeks. America was like, "Oh my God, Ebola, we're gonna get it. We're all gonna die." And then they came up with ISIS. And we're like, "Fuck Ebola, I'm afraid of ISIS." Now, I was like, if the media really wants to scare us, what they should do is they should say, "There's one guy from ISIS with Ebola." And he's on a plane. We don't know where, but he's coming to America. Ebisus. I'm glad to be in New York because I live in California, and it's way more multicultural here. This is like, you see everything here. California, it's like there's a little bit of white people and then like a lot of Mexicans. And you don't have Mexicans here. You got Puerto Ricans, which are like the kind of cousin. But you don't have a lot of Mexicans. And I live in California, so all my jokes are about Mexicans. So I'm like, fuck, I got to bring a few. That's my goal. I'm going to bring like 5 here. And then in like 6 weeks, you'll have like 80,000. No, seriously, they're like gremlins. You get them wet and they fucking multiply. I didn't hear anything you just said. It just sounded like a woman talking, and I'm really good at zoning that out. Because I'm married. But this next joke is a joke. I was having sex with this girl for this joke, and immediately afterwards, she cried like they all do if you choke them well enough. What? Choking's the new anal. And, So I'm choking the shit out. No, I'm joking. I didn't choke her. I swear to God. I made sweet love. I don't know how you make sweet love. It was sweet. I, like, kissed her. But we, like, made love, and she cried. I had a girl cry after sex. Not, like, tears of joy. Like, she cried, like, sadness, and that's not good. And then she goes, this is true, she goes, "I have something to tell you." That's never good after sex. That's never followed by something like, "I have the best score on Candy Crush ever." She goes, "I have something to tell you." I go, "Well, you better tell me." She goes, "I have cancer." And I was like, "Woo, well, that's not contagious. Holy shit, you scared me. That's a you problem. That's not a we problem. Don't ever do that shit again. You almost gave me a heart attack, you selfish bitch. Think about somebody else once. Once in your life. Oh my God, seriously, what a bitch. Oh, so, a lot of black people here. I like black people. Black people are awesome. White people, I watch the news. You and your guns, you need to shut the fuck up. White people, if you want to keep your guns, shut the fuck up. I watch the news every time there's a school shooting, like every week, and they do an argument for the guns. White people come on and talk about the guns. You need to shut up. You just need to shut. You ever see them? They're on there. They're like, the government's never going to take my guns. It's my constitutional right. You want to take my guns? You got to come to my house. You're going to have to pry them out of my cold, dead hands. You want to keep your guns. Learn from black people. You ever watch black people on the news? They're like, guns? No gun here. I didn't see a gun. Anybody see a gun? I didn't see a gun. Nobody saw a gun. I didn't see a gun. Nobody's got a gun. You don't know my name? I don't know my name. Yeah. Thank you, guys. You guys are, you're here. I'm here. Thank you. Thank you. I'm ready to go. Thank you.
Stay tuned for more laughs on Access TV, live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City.
So I have to kill 30 seconds, all right? So let's talk about Viagra because my husband's on it. And it's like, who needs this goddamn drug? It's like, what are we going to be faking orgasms into our golden years now? Oy, were you great? Yeah, fantastic is the word to... Who needs it? And some of these old guys, they're 90. Let's picture an old guy, 90, naked on Viagra. Now, what is the point? It's like putting a flagpole on a condemned building. Okay, I'm gonna bring up the comics now. Come on. Thank you so much for the wonderful audience. Sean Jackson.